In this video, I'm going to build a fine woodworking mallet. Starting with a piece of oak, I'm going to throw it in the vise, measure out 6 inches, and mark it with a V. This tells me exactly where that 6-inch mark is. I'm going to take a square and scribe right across that V, nice and dark. I'm going to take my finger as a guide, set up my saw, and cut across the face of this piece of wood, just outside the line, trying to use the whole saw as I cut. When I get down to the end, I want to go really easy so I don't split the wood. All right, now I'm going to take the oak and cut one more piece at 6 inches. Same thing, just outside the line, nice and easy so it doesn't split. Piece of walnut at 6 inches. Nice and easy. All right, now I've got 3 pieces of wood, 2 oak and 1 walnut, and I'm off to the glue table. At the glue table, I'm going to use wood screw clamps, and I'm going to dry clamp it. That means without glue. This way I get the clamps to fit, everything's set up before I apply glue to the wood. Looks good. I'm going to take these off, apply a little glue to the oak. Make sure that you cover all the wood, a little bit on this side. All right, now I'm going to put my wood screw clamps back on, and they should go on really easy because they're already adjusted. All right, after this, I'm going to grab a bucket of water, and a rag and a brush, and I'm going to clean up not only my block of wood, but the glue table. Now, the most important step. Write your name and the period on the block of wood, because there's going to be like 100 blocks of wood that look just like yours, and you want to be able to tell yours apart. All right, back to the workbench and into the vise. I'm going to take a square and check how square my block of wood is, marking the high spots with a pencil. Now I'm going to take a hand plane and hand plane those high spots down. The whole point here, trying to get the block as square as possible. Gonna check it again, fine tune it, and come back and finish it up with a block plane. It's a smaller version of a plane. And check it one last time. All right, so I'm gonna flip the block over and do the exact same thing to the other side. Checking for square, hitting it with the hand plane, coming back and finishing up with the block plane, and then I'm going to check to make sure that it's square. All right, my block of wood's back in the vise. I'm gonna measure down about 1 inch, take my square, go ahead and scribe across that line. Then I'm going to go ahead and mark it all the way around the block until I have 4 lines that connect. Then I'm back in the vise. Now I'm going to take a handsaw and cut halfway down. Now I'm going to take it out, rotate it, do the same thing, cut about halfway down. Rotate it and do this until I cut all the way through. Now the reason we're cutting it from all 4 sides is I found it's an easier way for a first-time woodworker to make a square cut on the end of a hardwood block like this. Now I'm going to measure down 4 inches from the end I just cut, take my square and scribe across my V again. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go ahead and square it all the way around until I have 4 lines that connect. And back in the vise, and I'm going to go ahead and cut it again, same way. So what I'm doing here is I'm checking the ends to see how square they are. And I'm going to go ahead and put this in the vise with a backing block. A backing block is a piece of wood that you put behind the piece that you're planing to keep it from splitting out. And I'm going to use a block plane for this. I find it a lot easier to do with a block plane, holding it at an angle. All right, I'm going to pull it out of the vise. Once again, I'm checking to see how square it is. And I'm going to flip it over, put my backing block behind it again, and do the same thing to the other end.
Square. No gaps on either end. Checking both ways and all sides. Square is square.
All right, back at vise, I'm gonna go ahead and mark the diagonals from corner to corner. This is some basic geometry that's gonna help me find the center. Once I do that, I'm off to the drill press and into the vise with my diagonals up, and I'm gonna drill through until the bit just barely pokes out the other side, and I'll have it set up for you this way. After I do that, I'm gonna release it and flip the block over. There should be a little hole on the other side, and finish it up. Now we need to make a round hole square. I'm gonna take our square and scribe to the edge of the circle, coming both ways. And on both sides. Next, we're going to take a chisel, a 1-inch chisel or less, and chisel all the way around the square that we just marked, rotating, and we're going to chisel halfway down, trying to keep that chisel as straight as possible. Once we get halfway, we're going to take the block out and chisel from the other direction. This way we don't split out the back, and it actually goes a lot faster this way. Once we get to the middle, a little cleanup, we should have a square hole, if such a thing exists. Next, we want to make sure that our 1x1 handle fits. If not, make any proper adjustments. A snug fit is a good fit. Next, we're going to take the mallet head off, and we're going to cut the handle to 10 inches in length. As square as possible. All right, now clamp it vertically, mark 1.5 inches down. Go ahead and you can mark your cut line with a pencil. We're going to take a handsaw and cut all the way down to that line. This is going to be the slot that we drive the wedge in. Speaking of wedge, we got to make that next. 1/4 inch wide on one end, 1.5 inches down. Take a straight edge and connect them. Clamp it in the vise vertically and cut the wedge. It doesn't need to be perfect, it just needs to come to an absolute point. All right, time to assemble. A little glue in the mortise. And we're going to go ahead and place the mallet head on. I like to leave a little bit sticking out, about 1/4 inch or so. Take the wedge, clean up the excess glue, get a little in the slot, and then drive that wedge home. To avoid the mallet head splitting, make sure the wedge is perpendicular to the grain direction. After trimming the wedge on the mortise and tenon, we're going to go ahead and break the edge of the mallet head all the way around. For this, we're going to use a block plane and a rasp. It's like a file. You can do it to your preference, a little or a lot, it's up to you. But the thing here is to make it look really good. All right, here we are finishing up the bottom. Next, we're going to take a rasp and shape the handle. Once again, shape it to your liking. You can make it any design you want. Things to keep in mind are making it comfortable, making it functional so it doesn't slip out of your hand, and adding some design to it. After that, we're gonna take a palm sander and we're gonna sand our mallet down, starting with 100 grit, 180, and then lastly 320. So it's smooth as a baby's butt. Now it's time to add your name or a little bit of art. First doing a pencil, then come back with the wood burner and carefully go over your lines. Careful not to burn your hand. These things are wicked hot. When you're done doing the wood burning, go over it with 180 sandpaper just to kind of knock down the edge of the burn. And we're off to the stain room. Here we're going to apply a water-based stain with a brush. And we're not painting here, we're just getting the stain on as quickly as we can. And then we're gonna follow up with a rag and wipe it off. These are wiping stains meant to be wiped off. After that, we're gonna go ahead and put it in the finish room where it says project's ready for clear coat.